2014 is the year of the Super Naked. Now, we've already put three of the challengers together head to head in a test a few months ago, where the Aprilia Tuono beat the KTM new Super Duke and the Triumph Speed Triple. But now, with the arrival of the BMW S1000R and the Monster 1200, we can do a more comprehensive test. And we've also added in the new Z1000 into the mix as well, which is Japan's best stab at being the Super Naked King. So what's going to be different with this test? We're going to be riding them on the road again, but we've also got a track element. We're going to take all the bikes to Anglesey Circuit, and we're also going to do a full performance testing. So without further ado, let's do some wheelies. Anglesey Circuit on day three of our very intensive Super Nakeds test. The first day we were at Bruntingthorpe doing performance testing. Some interesting things that came out of that was that the Aprilia was the fastest, 165 mile an hour, although that's not really a naked, is it? It's got a fairing to help it through the wind. KTM was 161 mile an hour and the BMW 159 mile an hour, so not a lot in them. The BMW did 150 mile an hour in 14 seconds, which is very, very fast. Then we went on the road and we all love the bikes. They're great fun, but they're kind of comfortable as well, unlike a sports bike. And the three best bikes that came out of that was the KTM, Tuono and BMW. For riders like me who just want to have loads and loads of fun and muck about, the KTM's electronics are frustrating. But for the other guys, to be fair to the KTM, they really liked it. They don't pull wheelies or skid about, so they didn't notice the electronics were holding them back. They just liked the safety of the electronics, the lightweight of the KTM, and its attitude. So all three of them are quite level pegging, but now we're here on the track and we're going to ride the bikes around the circuit. We're going to use a short layout with the corkscrew. We're not actually going to do lap times because all the bikes have got different tyres, so the bike with the best tyre would be the fastest, but we're going to get a general idea of what's what and really let these Super Nakeds off the leash.
It's the best kept secret, most slept on. Keep that dirt off me like I was Teflon. I'm bringing money parts, little dude, you know I spit darts. Take part, join me as I grasp mics and grip hearts. Take notice, confuse me not. I'm not here to snatch souls and serve the fiends on the block. I'm no killer, but I got fam who's serving time for busting shots. Lesson learned the hard way, succumb to the devil's plot. Losing years, but he'll be back stronger. So I'm holding it down just a little bit longer. And when the whole team come back to combine, those who stand against in the poses, wartime, but we can keep it kosher. Let the grown men talk, leave the guns in a holster. Let the bullshit walk, but let me know if you want it, you can get it. But the outcome for all of us is something we gon' regret, kid. Yeah. Like you're all in the same boat, got similar dreams, just trying to stay afloat. Fighting off there was a fiend, some would love to see it fall. Not living our dreams, but if we all combine, we can do incredible things. We all in the same boat, got similar dreams, just trying to stay afloat. Fighting off there was a fiend, some would love to see it fall.
The Kawasaki is very good in small blasts, but on the road it's a bit too short geared, it's a bit too buzzy, and on the track it runs out of revs too quickly again. There's not a lot of ground clearance, not a lot of room to move around the bike, and it's quite snatchy on the throttle. Then we've got the Ducati Monster. Is it a super naked? No, it's not. So it was a bit unfair to include it into this test. It's more like a mini Diavel, a mini cruising bike. Great engine, great chassis, but more for cruising and not for wheeling and mucking around the racetrack. Then we got the Speed Triple. Now the Speed Triple has been our group test winner for years and years and years, but in today's company it's a little bit underpowered. Even though it handles really nicely and it's got great brakes, it feels a little bit old in this company. So then we've got the top three bikes, which are these three here. Now we've got the BMW, the new kid on the block. Now if you want to go absolutely mentally fast, this is the bike, but around the track it's actually quite flighty. It doesn't actually feel that planted around the track, although it's really fast and it's got the best brakes. And on the road, being an inline four-cylinder bike, it kind of lacks a little bit character. So at low speed, it's not as much fun as the others. And it's got a very long riding position, so you've got quite a long stretch to the bars. So it's not the winner of this test, and neither is the KTM. KTM around the track is probably one of the nicest to ride. It's got the best steering, feels the most racy. The traction control is actually really good around the track. It's got really good tyres, Sportsmart 2s on it. Really good fun, doesn't wheelie, doesn't skid. You've got to turn the electronics off for that, but it doesn't really bother that many people. Probably only worries a few people like me. So the winner of this test is the Aprilia Tuono. This thing just does everything so well. Around the track, it's planted, it's fast, it handles superbly, the brakes are wonderful, the electronics are the smoothest, most refined, it comes on the best tyres. On the road, it's got the most character. That V4 engine is just sensational. Maybe the only criticism is a little bit cramped, but apart from that, it's actually got some wind protection. So is it really a naked? Probably not, but we'll give it a super naked tag. And just overall, everybody loved it. Everybody loved its character and what it stands for. So it's been a great test, but the 2014 super naked winner is the Aprilia Tuono V4R ABS.